Well, that's certainly a novel way of getting listeners. On tonight's programme, we've got the debut session from Leisure Process, also a repeat of that from the Twin Sets. Amongst the records, Playgroup, The Sinatras, Simple Minds, Killing Joke, Carlton Lewis, Can Can, New Age, Willie Williams, Cabaret Voltaire, Pete Shelley, Echo and the Bunny Men, The Yellow Man, and a great many more. She's stirring up Alley Alley.
She's stirring up, she's stirring up the race, 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 she's
Alley Alley, a single on Scalp Records. You can also get it on a 12-inch EP, in fact, and that's called She's Stirring Up. The whole world is dance crazy. Not for long, I suspect, though. In another 6 months, I reckon they'll be back to sitting on the floor. Audiences sitting on the floor, grinning foolishly to themselves. I can't wait for that. This is from Yellow Man.
Yeah.
That's the thoroughly wonderful Yellow Man. It's called 2 to 6 Supermix from a new LP on Green Sleeves, Mr. Yellow Man, which has got a fine photograph on the front of it of Yellow Man himself, wearing what looks disquietingly like an Everton shirt, but I'm sure this is just a temporary aberration. From the twin sets, Stranded in the Jungle.
Message back home, but how is that?
strangest faces in the crowd to me. Those are the twin sets and that's Stranded in the Jungle. I was horrified reading today's paper to discover that the Norwegians actually think they've got a pretty good song for this year's Eurovision Song Contest, because one of the high points of the whole year is listening to the Norwegian song being sung for the first time and then seeing it as it fails to score any points throughout the whole exciting competition. And if they're actually going to have a good one this year, it'll really rather spoil it, I think. I think they should reconsider. Write to your Norwegian friends and tell them to do something about it. This is Echo and the Bunnymen from the LP, whatever it's called, about Lake Placid. Read it in books. Oh, no, it isn't, you know. Hold on a second. It only took me a matter of seconds to spot that. This is Echo and the Bunnymen. Come on, be fair. Well, apart from forgetting the title of the LP, playing the wrong track and getting the title of the track wrong as well, I got almost everything in the preceding announcement right. From the LP to the shores of Lake Placid, Echo and the Bunnymen, and that's Read It in Books. And I was playing that for the people of Nag 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 fanzine of Darlington, an organ which presumably derives its name from this. We'll be right back. That's Cabaret Voltaire, of course, and Nag 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 from yesteryear. And I was as glad as anybody was, I suppose, when the popular music, when the direction of popular music turned to dancing again, because I must confess that a year or so ago, I was deeply worried that what happened at the end of the 1960s was going to happen again. You know, when audiences actually did end up sitting on the floor, you know, chaps sitting there nodding, waiting for quotes from obscure Central European composers, over which Geordies usually would bellow half-baked poetry, or so it seemed to me anyway. And but what always happens is that there's too much of a good thing, and now every single record listened to over the weekend just about was a dance record, usually with somebody who'd just left Charterhouse rapping. Well, I know you can say, point to me as a single record with somebody who's just left Charterhouse rapping on it, but you know what I mean. The point's the same. The best LP that I listened to over the whole of the weekend was one on Plurex Records by Nasmack, which you're going to hear quite a lot of on these programmes, I think, providing that I survive to tomorrow. This is Pilot in Charge. You'll hear more from this, of that you can be sure. That's, well, reasonably sure. Nasmack, the band, and it's an LP on Plurex, and that was called Pilot in Charge. Here's a rather worrying note, which I just opened, from somebody calling themselves Fell on My Stereo. In the writing from a Staplehurst in Kent, he says, "Dear John, your voice is very much more piercing through my headphones. Please try to speak with more bass when I wear them." Actually, this is something that I have noticed myself. On the very rare occasions when I catch any of my work coming out over the radio, my voice does seem to be getting more and more high-pitched all the time, and I can only assume that I'm in some way, something to do with my age, I expect, reversing through puberty, which should be an interesting experience, if nothing else. This is from Pete Shelley, "Qu'est-ce que c'est que ça?" Special exotic dub, disco, whatever it is, version. From New Sounds, New Styles, the other way around. Yeah. Botticelli and a special version mixed by Martin Rushent, of course, which is comes to you with the magazine New Sounds, New Styles, of Qu'est-ce que c'est que ça? And a lot of mail today. I was very pleased. I thought, finally, the programme is taking off after all of these years. But it turns out that most of the letters and postcards are entries in Bruce Grobbelaar competition of last week, which already had a winner, actually, one E. Nadler, which is an anagram of Randall. I wonder if Nadler's his real name. But anyway, E. Nadler of something close, Borley Close, London, West 1. Just around the corner, probably dropped the record off. And he won that Californian, whatever it is, something beach compilation LP. I really ought to come to these programmes armed with more information, I think, on occasion. Here's a nice letter, too, one of the letters which I opened, from Maria, writing from Battersea. I seem to be getting a lot more letters from London these days. Does this mean that the recession has finally reached the south? Probably does. And Maria wanted me to play something of a reggae-ish nature for Andy, Sean, Sally Vander, Megran, it looks like, Penny, Steve, Tony, Don, and also for Frida, Herb, and DBC, whatever that means. This is from Watty Burnett, and it's called Dancing Shoes.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I want to rock with you, my baby.
Mixed by Mikey Dread, and on Dread of the Controls Records, a 12-inch, that's Watty Burnett and Dancing Shoes. I realise that it's a hopelessly wet kind of liberal attitude to have, but I've always been slightly embarrassed, if not offended, by Irish jokes. And I've got, like, a really good friend who's Irish. I mean, I suppose we all have. And I was walking around a shop in Bury St Edmunds a few months ago with him, and I was really embarrassed at the number of things you saw, sort of like Irish coat hangers or something. You know, it's just discharge your coat onto the floor and stuff like this. And I know a lot of people don't bother about it at all. And they was, oh, the Irish tell more Irish jokes than anybody else, but they always make me feel uneasy. Actually, funnily enough, when I phoned him last week, he got somebody to tell me that he was in a meeting, but this is the kind of thing which happens to me. But there's a wonderful little letter here from somebody saying, which ends with an Irish joke, which isn't terribly funny under any circumstances, I don't think. And he says, what do you call an Irishman who says he's got O-levels? Answer, a liar. And Robert Attrill and John Evanett have spelled liar wrong. Jolly good. Well done, boys. Leisure Process, and this is The Erection Set. Wonderful. That's Leisure Process, the first from them. That's called The Erection Set. Sounds like the theme music from some film that you'd quite like to see. These are the Twin Sets and Johnny Come Home. Me knocking on your dough. Those are the Twin Sets, Johnny Come Home, and from Willie Williams, one of a series of slates, that's what we have to call them, or is it plates? One forgets so easily. On Music Lab, anyway, and terribly expensive, and you can get them at the right shops, or the wrong shops, really. Willie Williams, and this is Jah Righteous Plan.
Refuse to give your praise. All they do is continue in them stubborn ways, just cheating, backbiting, and all them sinful things, using your righteous name to achieve their own glory and fame. Ooh, 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 ooh. We have a dream. Talking about it, how you change your ways. I said, imagine, come on, why don't you check your righteous plan? Come on, come on, come on. Hey, don't you love your brother? So how can you look tough? Oh, no, no, no. Gotta get away, gotta get away, yeah. Judge and crucify Christ. How come you they follow them? Do you know them on the peer of Christ? Oy, 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 oy. Come on, stop it, change it. Why don't you do that shit? Change your ways, me, I enjoy. Yes, me, brethren, come on. Why don't you check your righteous path? Come on. Come on, come on, I say, jump, jump, jump. Gotta get away, gotta get away, jump, set, jump. Gotta get away, gotta get away, I said, see. crucified Jesus Christ. Upon you they followed them. Do you know them on the fear of Christ? Oy, 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 have mercy. Oy, oy, why don't you come on? Yes, we are you. Yes, we pray to you.
That's a 10-inch single to us plain down-to-earth, no-nonsense folks, Willie Williams, and it's on Music Lab Records. Jar Righteous Plan, the title of it. And from a new 12-inch from Can Can, spelt with two Ks, of course, as I'm sure you know, on Dining Out, this is Laugh, Clown, Laugh. We'll be right back. 10 now, I think, from a 12-inch EP by Can Can on Dining Out Records, Laugh Clown Laugh, and the catalogue number of it is Tux 17, whereas Tux 18 is a new 12-inch by New Age, and you'll have heard a session from them on Kid Jensen's programme, and also I understand he played a track from the EP earlier in the programme, I mean, in his programme, of course, not in this one, hopefully not this track.
Thank you.
That's New Age, and on Dining Out Records again. Two in the back of the net for Dining Out, I'd say, in fact, with Can Can and that. And that's called Amazed, one of four tracks on a 12-inch EP. Did I say that before? An extraordinary number of actual entries for our Bruce Grobbelaar competition. As I say, the winners... Extraordinary number of entries, as I say, and most of them terribly amusing, I must say that as well. I should like to read them all out to you, but it'll take the rest of the programme, and those of you who aren't interested in football probably wouldn't appreciate the small joke anyway. But I think Bruce Grobbelaar's wonderful myself, I must admit. I mean, I know he does makes the occasional mistake, but at the same time, I think he's worth it. I mean, like, for me to go up to Anfield is something like a 495-mile round trip from where I live. In fact, it's exactly a 495-mile round trip, and I'm prepared to go there in order to see Bruce in action, I must say. This is from Joe Tex and Papa's Dream.
Lord have mercy. This time last year there were a lot of sad faces around this old house. Our Papa had died without fulfilling his life's dream of producing one of the best crops in Grimes County. But he never did fulfill that dream. No, Papa died with that dream still in his head, a desire in his heart, a promise on his lips, calluses on both hands, and $2 in his pocket. Papa didn't live long enough to see his dream come true. So he died with too much work, a broken spirit, I guess. A promise to our mama that if it was the last thing he'd ever do, he'd live long enough to see just one good crop come through. But you see, we can't plan on things without first talking to God, because we don't know his plans. And if we don't include him, my friends, the way can get mighty hard. They say every time a good and righteous person is buried in God's good earth, is just fertilized for the soil. And I guess there must be some truth to that, whether we believe it or not. I just wish that Pop was here right now so he could see this good crop that we finally got. Oh, man, look at them beans. And look at that cone. And I bet them watermelons must be 3 feet long. And look at them tomatoes. And just look at them beans. I know if my Papa was here right now, he'd sure be pleased. And Papa would sure be proud of his children, too. Junior's up north somewhere, they tell me, playing with some famous band. Of course, that boy always did love music. He loved to travel here and there. I'm so proud for him. And baby sister, well, they tell me old Mesu got herself one of them beautician jobs, making good money, y'all, fixing other folks' hair. Ain't nobody here at the house but me and Mama now. Oh, Mama, it's getting weaker and she getting older every day, and she talks often about joining Papa in his heavenly home. Lord, that woman sure did love that man. She worked beside Papa for 40-some years trying to produce a good crop and never could grow a single bean. But I just wish that Papa was here right now to see this good crop that we finally got. Good God Almighty, man, will you look at them beans? Man, look at that cone. And them watermelons must be at least 3 feet long. Man, look at them tomatoes. And just look at them peas. Yeah, I know if Papa was here right now, the old man would sure be pleased. And Papa, if you can hear me, we finally got us one.
Wonderful hokum from Joe Tex, and that's Papa's Dream from the LP. What LP on dial, actually, if I suppose from the early 1970s. Let's have a look and see when it was. 1972, Joe Tex Spills the Beans. Great stuff, I think. From Killing Joke, Empire Song.
Shut down.
Killing Joke and the current single, which is Empire Song, and probably another track from the forthcoming LP before the end of the week. I mean, I know that sounds like a hopelessly wet thing to say, but they gave me a copy of it on condition that I didn't go whacking it all out on the radio before it was available in the shops. It's marketing, marketing, you know how it goes. From the twin sets, I'll Remember You. Not, and no, it's not, surely. I've heard it before. It's not, I'll Remember You. Of the twin sets, I expect it's just indigestion, and it's very difficult, you know, with requests and things on the radio, as I mentioned before, because most of the letters that you get are actually very amiable letters. You get extraordinarily few unpleasant ones, and you always feel like these people, you know, it's not going to take up that much time to read out their request on the radio and so on, but then at the same time, it's infinitely tedious for the people who are not being mentioned. So I suppose in the time that I've been explaining all of this, I could have mentioned several people, like, for example, Sandy Graham, who was 21 on Saturday, and this is something I was supposed to do last week, actually. It says from Ira, it looks like I-R-E-H, surely it can't be, Tosh, Dougie and Joss. My apologies for being late. And I got a letter from Rosie Evans saying that her little brother Joe is studying away in his little room at the top of Block A of Pembroke College in Cambridge, and he likes this sort of thing. Mm-hmm. a mighty sound, as we disc jockeys call records, and that's Joe Liggins and the Honey Dripper from years ago. It's almost somebody who has to spoil things, isn't there? There's a letter from David Home of Abingdon asking me to dedicate The Silence After a Sudden Ending to Alan in Tooting. Very funny, David, indeed. This is from Leisure Process. Give me that sax, boy. Terrific, that. That's Leisure Process, and you must know that that's Ross Middleton, vocals, guitar and bass, and Gary Barnacle, it says keyboards and saxophone here, and why not? That's Gimme That Sax Boy, derived from Captain Beefheart's Gimme That Heart Bow, of course, which I should have played you to follow it, in fact, but next time the session goes out, I'll play Gimme That Heart Boy as well as Gimme That Sax Boy. This is from Carlton Lewis, Sweet Soul Rockin'. That's another 10-inch job, this time on Top Notch Records by Carlton Lewis, Sweet Soul Rockin', the title of it. And if you listen to tomorrow night's programme, and I certainly hope that you will, then you'll hear a session from these folk.
Trod this land, we walk for one reason. The reason is to try to help another man to think for himself. The music of our art is roots music, music which recalls history. Because without the knowledge of your history, you cannot determine your destiny. The music about the present is if you're not conscious of the present, you're like a cabbage in this society. Music which tells about the future and the judgment which is to come. The music of our artist Roots presenting Misty in Roots.
Roots music for everybody. I like to say good evening or good morning. This one called Mankind, You a Sinner. Yeah.